Hello students, and welcome back to Pair of Lines. Here in this module, we are going to learn pair of lines passing through origin. So we will see details of two lines when they pass through origin. So here we say theorem number 2. Theorem number 2 says equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0 represents a pair of lines passing through the origin if h square minus ab is greater than or equal to 0. So we need to prove that this homogeneous equation of degree 2 represents pair of lines passing through origin if h square minus ab is greater than or equal to 0. So here we do the proof in cases. Let us consider the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0. Let us call it equation number 1. Here a, b, h are constants. Now we consider two cases, students. Case 1. In this equation, let b is equal to 0. That is, constant b becomes 0. If b is equal to 0 and a and h are non-zero numbers, then equation 1 will become ax square plus 2hxy equal to 0. That is, we can simplify x into ax plus 2hy equal to 0. Now here we can say either x is equal to 0 or ax plus 2hy equal to 0. Now students, if you concentrate on these equations, here the first equation is equation of y-axis, that is x equal to 0. And the second equation is equation of a line passing through origin, that is ax plus by equal to 0. That means we can conclude when b is 0, constant b is 0, both the lines represented by the equation pass through origin, right? And therefore we say if b is equal to 0, the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0 represents two lines which pass through the origin, right? Let us consider case 2. In case 2, we say let b is not equal to 0. Now in this equation, we divide by x square on both sides to get ax square upon x square plus 2hxy upon x square plus by square upon x square equal to 0. Now here x square and x can be cancelled from first two terms and we get a plus 2h into y by x plus b into y by x square is equal to 0. Now students, b into y by x square plus 2h into y by x plus a equal to 0. So if we put y by x as m, then m is a variable and we get the equation as bm square plus 2hm plus a equal to 0, right? Now as this is quadratic in terms of m, let us try to solve this further. Now if we compare this with am square plus bm plus c, we get a as small b, b as 2h and c as small a, right? Now the roots of the quadratic equation are minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a, right? So in this case they become m equal to minus 2h plus or minus root of 4h square minus 4ba divided by 2b, right? When we simplify further, m is equal to minus 2h plus or minus 2 into root of h square minus ab upon 2b, right? And this becomes y by x equal to minus h plus or minus root of h square minus ab upon b, right? So we can say y equal to minus h plus or minus root of h square minus ab upon b into x, where y equal to mx is the format here. That means this is the joint equation of lines whose separate equations are y equal to minus h plus root of h square minus ab upon b into x and y equal to minus h minus root of h square minus ab upon b, right students? Now both these lines are of the type y equal to mx, right? Therefore we can say here the root sign will exist only if h square minus ab is greater than or equal to 0, right? And these lines will also pass through the origin. That means from case 1 and 2, we can say or we can conclude that the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0 represents pair of lines passing through the origin. Alright? So here we complete the proof. Now, let us try one question here. Question says, find the separate equation of the lines represented by x square minus 4xy plus y square equal to 0. Let us take this equation. If we divide by x square, we get y upon x the whole square minus 4y upon x plus 1 equal to 0. Now students, as the line passes through origin, we can say y is equal to mx. So we can put y by x as m and we get m square minus 4m plus 1 equal to 0. Now as this is a quadratic in terms of m, let us get the values very fast. For quadratic, we already have the expression from the proof. So we get m is equal to 4 plus or minus square root of 4 square minus 4 into 1 into 1 divided by 2. On simplification, this becomes m is equal to 4 plus or minus square root of 12 upon 2, which is either gives 4 plus or minus 2 root 3 upon 2, and this becomes m equals to 2 plus or minus root 3. Now students, we assumed y by x as m, so re-substitute m by y by x, we get y upon x is equal to 2 plus or minus root 3. Now this equation can give us two answers, right? What are they? Therefore, the separate equations are y equal to 2 plus root 3 times x or y equal to 2 minus root 3 times x. So if we need separate equations of two lines, we solve in this manner. All right, students. So here we started studying lines passing through origin. Thank you.